today is such an unprecedented moment for our community, and we hope other communities can use our creativity and establish their own momentum to build on their team. Yes, we do. We have the Mario Woods Coalition. We also have Calle 24, which is an organization in the mission for small business owners. And they're getting driven out because of gentrification. We have students here. We have students from colleges, and I understand those students as well. So, I've seen such a popular of beautiful, inspirational people. And we're here all for love and justice for Alex Nieto and his parents.
Powerful faith tradition, all of us together in this moment of prayer and of preparation. So I woke up at 5 o'clock this morning, and ever since then, echoing in my mind has been the words of an ancient prophet when his people were going through the kinds of things we've been going through these past few years. Here's how he described it. A voice is heard in Ramah, mourning and great weeping. Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because they are no more. And that very same cry echoes to our own time. It echoes all throughout our city, from the Nieto family home on Bernal Heights to the home of Mario Woods, all the way to a poor village in Guatemala where Amilcar's family lives and mourns this day. All across our country, weeping and mourning for our children, refusing to be comforted because they are no more. We enter into this moment, sometimes we speak through tears, sometimes our knees are shaking a little bit, but we speak. And we remember that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but one of power and love and a good mind. And we summon that gift of the Creator as we enter into this day of the civil trials. Power, love, and a good mind. And I'd like to take a moment to bless you, to extend that to you, using a symbol from my own tradition. The symbol of water, the gift of the Creator, the gift of the earth. We can't live without it. Sometimes after so much grief and so much trauma, so much heartache, so much loss, we need once again to summon the spirit of life that God so very much wants to give us. So would you join me in asking a blessing on our time together? May the Creator bless us with discomfort and easy answers and half-truths and the lies of the powerful, that we may live with integrity deep within our hearts. May the Creator bless us with anger and injustice and oppression and the abuse of our people by the powerful, that we may end the violence that has cut short too many lives, left too many moms and dads in tears. May the Creator bless us with tears for those who mourn and weep for their children, the parents of Alex, of Amilcar, of Mario, and so many other victims of police violence, that we may dry their tears and turn their cries for justice into solid hope for a new world. And may the Creator bless each of us. Each of us. With enough foolishness to believe that we can make a difference in this world, that we can do what others claim cannot be done, bring justice and love, joy and hope to our families and communities who struggle each day to live in dignity and peace. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Gracias. Gracias, Father Richard. We love you. We love you and all
our prayers. Truth to power, orale. These walls are gonna come tumbling down. Listo, vamos. Can you say amor por Ale?
Amor por Ale.
If you can say it, you can sing it. Orale. Amor por Ale. For a brother who gave up his life so we love one another. Yeah.
Amilcar Perez-Lopez, Kenneth Harding, Alan Hoover, Oscar Grant, Nidra Shelley, Andy Lopez, Michael Brown, Eric Garner, Walter Scott, Trayvon Martin, and all the black, brown, and all the black and brown men shot down in cold blood a los manos de la policía. There are tones of blood-soaked wounds and uniform behavior, enforcers of Jim Crow and Juan Crow. One heart, el corazón de la misión. Chin pointed to the sun, cruising with gold ferris wheel rims, and Tupac sings, Hail Mary, can you hear me? Skyscrapers, headstone blocks of tomb. Here's to the young roses subjected to premature death, trying to do what Tupac said and grow up from the concrete when no one else even cares. This one goes out to all the chaparitos and chaparitas, to the little shorties with their bridges on sag, the little shorties sporting woven hoop pants, to the kids duking it out with that truck dancing when the V explodes, flexing and cracking their bodies in space, defying Cobra 5-0 playing Jim Crow. Defying Po-Po 5-0 playing Jim Crow. They get hypey with E-40 and his thugs, Jismadel, beating up death like a conga drum, rewriting a sum. From the aching vibrations, quaking in the palms that spray, from a plastic nozzle in a tin can, onto the face of a midnight train, to the lost warriors on lockdown in duty, to the heart attack blood-pumping lyrics on the brick walls of opportunity, to the ciphers of young people spit river currents of life, poems that champion and affirm their life, their life, their life. Mariposa, casting out their dreams from a bottomless shore.
And we will no longer accept being the fuel that drives that into the profit, while our people, our young men, and especially now our young women, who are the largest growing segment of the business population, continue to feed that monster, whether it's through tankers, shields, or tanks, but no more profit for the prison industrial complex. And the other thing I want to say, and I want to challenge London Breed and the chief of police and the mayor, for them to begin the de-escalation of this conflict, because it is the police and the media that have made the people an enemy, not the people making the police the enemy. So I challenge these civic leaders to send patrols of unarmed police into our neighborhood. And if the San Francisco Police Department cannot find 2 or 3 or more officers to patrol our streets unarmed, then I have a serious problem. I'm going to offer a poem in honor of Alex Nieto, because it seems that in our country, in a corporation of people, but people are targets. It seems like we're living in a Alice in Wonderland world, an upside down world, el mundo al revés. It's a strange world we're living here, where fat buzzards perch on trees, while good food lies on the ground, and all around, children with their bare feet. It's a strange world we're living here. There's some hard knocks on this block, where everywhere you look, there's heavily armed cops and a body or two, like Alex Nieto, that have never had a chance to scream. Stop. No, there's some hard knocks on my door. Es el mundo al revés, donde van corriendo los peces y los pajaritos nada, y los gatos pardos nada, pues es el mundo al revés. It's a strange scene on this street, where you're taught to lie and cheat, but in the end, it doesn't matter who you are. You're just another piece of meat, because it's a weird scene on the left. The strange world is selling here, where no one looks you in the eye, and the budget goes for hate and war and fear. So the best. Latin with Asie, en el segundo, Asie. Alex Nieto, presente.
Gracias, Alejandro. Gracias for blessing us with that hope. Okay? Now, it is also another opportunity to hear from a community politician, which almost sounds like a contradiction. Okay? All right? But we got one here. Okay? His name is John Alvaro. My good friend, thank you for coming. Give us some of your words, brother. All right?
Thank you, brother. It's really great to see you all here today, this morning, in honoring justice and love for Alex Nieto. Your presence here makes such a difference. Your work organizing all these years, 2 years since Alex Nieto was shot down by the police department, has made a huge difference. When you are present before elected officials like myself, you put so much pressure on us to do the right thing, to be transparent in our actions, to make sure that we're working for you. And we need that. A couple years ago, in December, we had a resolution that was calling out our police departments all around the country and here in San Francisco for how they got down community members like Alex Nieto. And we talked about how we have racism in our police department. And my colleagues and my colleagues refused to admit that. But it only has taken the movement of people calling for justice, making sure our police department lives up to San Francisco values, that have actually flipped my colleagues to make sure that they're pushing on police reform. And what I've told is that the reforms that have been put in place have been discussed for years, and they just need some excuse, some reason to move forward on de-escalation, on monitoring the use of weapons. And they're doing that, but they're not doing it with the public, with the community. So your voices still matter in this process. They still matter to make sure that we get the oversight that we need, that we get to remove impunity that the police department have experienced year after year. Officer involved shooting, to make sure we get the justice we need. So thank you, and keep up the work. Make sure that the public eyes are on the elected officials, on the police department. That's the only thing that's going to make change. And you're making the road by walking. Justice for Alex Nieto!
Justice!
I vote for the people of San Francisco! Thank you. All right, and now we have a living legend in front of us. All right? And I truly mean that. And if you don't, you know, Uncle Ray Barbera. La pura neta right here. This man has been organizing, especially in the mission, since the 1960s, man. All right? It is my honor to introduce him. Okay? Here you go, Ray.
Viva!
The police killed me. Murdered me. Time for
will strip my body apart, forcing God, life, the same spread, my spirit into the clouds of eternal life. Into the clouds of eternal life. I am Alex Nieto. My mother's father was traumatized. My family parts of crying. My people disrespected. My school peers grieving. I'm Alex Nieto. The police took my body, but that's my spirit. Lives on. Lives on by this movement was justice for all. This movement was justice for all. My spirit lives on. You did not kill my spirit. The spirit did not die. My love for the people here today and every day. The God of love, spirit, pervades the entire universe. And live deep in our hearts. I am our example. Thank you, mother and father, for unending love and for leading this program. I am our example. I dare and challenge you to be strong, caring, and giving people. I dare and challenge you to be community organizers, advocates, and leaders for this movement. I dare challenge you to love. I dare challenge you with love in your heart to fight in this struggle to end injustice. I am Alex Nieto. The principles are for this movement is love and serve the people. Our mission is to end violence. I am Alex Nieto. I love you. 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 Viva la raza!
This building that is inherently protected, appropriately Kill
Police Commission and if you're the mayor of the city, when did you decide that? Because after Alex Nieto got killed, that's what she, sir, said. That this city made it a policy to shoot and kill if a police officer thought that he was a danger.
Fuck that.
What happened to the policy that we demanded and the reform that we fought for many years ago, that a mediator, a professional mediator, would come out in crisis situations? So we gotta talk about not just this child, and I don't want to hear about policy change, because we're sick and tired of, well, we gotta study this, and we gotta review this, and we gotta figure out what to do. Oh, hell no, it's pretty simple. Stop fucking killing people.
Yeah!
And shame on Mayor Ed Lee. And shame on the chief of police. And shame on the board of supervisors. All you other of them are guilty. I don't care if you're black or brown or Asian. You are guilty. After Alex Nieto died, they did silly shit to change their policy. Have they changed their policy?
No.
That ass wouldn't have got killed. Or you would wouldn't have got killed. But they didn't give a fuck. They didn't give a damn. But if it would have been a white boy from Pacific Heights, the son of Gavin Houston, guess what? They would have been fired. Would have been all violent. You know, and that's racism. From the very top to the very bottom. Alex Nieto. Nobody did nothing for Alex Nieto in this city. Not the mayor, not the board of supervisors, not the chief, and not the police commission. And now, all of a sudden, with Mario Wood, because it was caught on tape, now they're talking about apologizing, and we make a big deal about apologizing, but have they made any changes? No, they haven't done it. They got to have the Department of Justice come here. Exactly. Rocket science. It's about institutional change. And so that's what we got to fight beyond this trial, is to make sure that we not pressure public officials. We should not act as racist public officials. They should be doing the right thing. It's about human lives that are being affected here. The mother and father of Alex Nieto, the family for empowerment. We are joined by the Mario Wood Coalition right now, and Felicia Jones is going to come up.
We are the people!
We are the people!
Come on, for Alex Nieto!
this two-year struggle. And today, we're here for justice. Today, we're here for justice. And not just for Alex, but for Amilcar, for Mario, for Idris, for the 40 people that have been in crime since 2000 on behalf of the San Francisco Police Department. We're here for justice, our brothers and sisters, today. And this is just the first act. Just the first act in the play. We're not stopping until we get justice in our city. Black, brown, yellow, white, I don't care if you believe in justice, you come to this movement. Because we're here, and we're here to stay. So today, all of you, we are asking for your commitment today to keep coming out. We gotta go to City Hall, we gotta go to the State Capitol, wherever we gotta go, we're gonna get justice for our brothers and sisters, and we're not gonna let them beat us anymore. We're not gonna let them shoot us anymore. We're not gonna let them kill us anymore. Because you know what? No justice!
No peace!
No justice!
No peace!
No justice!
No peace!
Hold me a second. Yeah, how's everybody doing out here today? It's really good to see everybody out here standing for justice, standing for peace, and standing for equality. We've been on the front line for 22 years doing this work. I've been Alejandro's family on the Earl Heights, my first story from the gang. He was always talking about unity, and he was always talking about justice, trying to order and happen. So it's good to see that everybody standing out here who is willing to fight for a cause that's worthy, that he stood up for even before he wanted to even go to the community. And so watch this. This is not no coincidence or accident that you are here today, that he is here, because his spirit still fights. And even when we sit there and we talk, he's always talking about getting justice. And so he always talked about black and brown, how we were natural born allies, and we're supposed to get together, and we're supposed to fight. But unfortunately, they have to take somebody to lose their life. But he's not, just because he ain't here physically, doesn't mean that he's not here spiritually. And I was told, the way you win and you wage the war when you win the fight, it's not just a not everyday thing. It's the fight is won to the people who endure. It ain't about the strong, it's the one who can endure, who can be there long after all this happened. And that's why I'm saying 22 years, we've been banged for change on the front line. I see a lot of people sitting here who can get there, that most justice, who won't be. So you don't only want to be here when the camera's in your face, when the sun is shining, and all of a sudden, you want to be a part of something. You got to be a part of this every single day. Starting off with a little kid. Because a little kid don't know what's going on. Only going to teach you. And if you don't teach them in garbage, guess what? They're going to learn garbage. If you teach them the truth, and you know by example, by standing and doing it with the soldiers that's up here right now, that's what they're going to learn. So I encourage y'all, continue to stand firm in the fight. Because the fight ain't won to the strong or to the swift. It's the one who can endure. Thank you. Always power to the people. Gracias, Rudy. All right. We have Juana Teo coming on up. A straight warrior for us. And she also gave us a blessing with her dancing. As well, please come on up and tell us what
we don't buy their lies. When we are here and we are playing their game, we are very clear that justice comes from the actions that we all take together collectively, right? That it's going to take black and brown people to fight against police impunity. That's the only way that we can really seek justice. And adversity is rapidly changing, and we know San Francisco, the police department is only an agent that protects private interests. We are here committed to building black and brown unity. The Justice for Alex Nieto Coalition has been working hand in hand with a coalition that is growing and forming, that is representing the last 3% of black San Francisco. Because we know that the attacks on black communities, not just in San Francisco, but across the country, are interconnected with the struggle here for Alex Nieto and for the Latino community here who is struggling to stay in this city. And so we are here rather than love, because it's very easy to be angry at all the violence that we experience at the hands of SFPD. We are here because we love our community. We not only love Alex, we love ourselves, we love each other, and more most importantly, we love the future of the children that we are fighting for, to be able to have a future in this city. The children that Alex wanted to serve. We all have a responsibility to honor Alex through the actions that we take. The actions that we take every day. The last thing I'll say is that it's really important. I didn't personally get a chance to know Alex, right? He was someone that I started tapping at different actions and different events. And he really turned me out of these last 2 years being really active in the community, getting to know who he was as a person by the way of people who knew him and people he worked with. It was a shock to me that this person could have been my friend. This could have been somebody that I've got to know and collaborated with. So I challenge each of you to look to your left and to your right. You may not know someone here, but we have something in common. Our struggle is interconnected. We need to know each other because the way that we're going to win, not just against police brutality, not just against gentrification, not just against the prison industrial complex, it's by us coming together and looking at our own leadership. We can't expect the elected officials to change anything. The only change that happens is when it comes from the bottom, from the grassroots, and from our community. So I want to thank you all for being here for taking a stand. Again, I want to reiterate the importance of black and brown community and the importance of our young people, our young workers, our young freshmen, our young women, our young people. We'll continue to fight for San Francisco. Thank you very much.
Because that's all love. That is all love. All right?
Yeah.
Get to know each other. Give each other your names, all right? We are about to get to another aspect of the program, all right? We are blessed right now with a rapper, an activist, a straight, solid homie. His name is Equipto. Let's give it up for Equipto, everybody. Equipto, here you go, baby.
You got a stage and everything.
How's everybody feeling? Yeah. Proud to the people. Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. I go by Equipto, for those that don't know, San Francisco, born and raised, St. Luke's Hospital, 41 years, and I don't plan on going anywhere. Yeah. If any time is more important, I think this is the time to take our city back. You know what I'm talking about? We got this case of Alex Nieto, this justice for Mario Woods, and I think we just really need to spread the word. You know, black and brown is united right now, and it's never really been like this in my 41 years that I've seen this. I was raised in Bacchantia Park, Hayden Fillmore, so all my life I've been around black, brown, red, and yellow. And San Francisco, that's what we're known for. You know, we need to highlight that. The world is waiting to hear what San Francisco has to say. We are the home of the civil rights, we're home of the resistance, home of the struggle, and we need to unify and show that. Oakland is doing their thing beautifully. San Francisco needs to unite and come together. All us natives, all us longtime residents, we need to come together and fight for civil rights out here. They say this is the modern day civil rights, am I right? Then let's treat it like that. Let's show dedication, a little bit of commitment. And, you know, I just wanted to do a little verse for y'all. We did a song called Justice for Mario Woods. Ed Lee's doorstep, so we can't ignore it. Screaming we need justice for the pain that lies to killing the young and black and brown kids who's their target. So we fighting for these kids to be brought up on charges for the murdering from Frisco to Ferguson. Gentrified cities trying to make the change permanent. Developers, investors, intention to wipe out the culture, conditioning the mind of young soldiers. But if we organize in the name of Alex and Mario, unite every hood community in the barrio, stand up and show them that Black Lives Matter, the power of influence of entertainers and rappers, get together our demands of the committee and fight for it, then we gonna take back our city. Yeah. Power to the people, y'all. I'm out of here. I'm going for Alex, Justice Mario Woods. La Misha has been in this struggle for more than a decade, all right? She is someone who unfortunately also lost her son to a police killing, all right? And she has always, always fought for justice for families who have lost their loved ones to police killing, all right? She is actually the person who founded the Facebook page for Alex Nieto. And so I thank you, La Misha, and here I got you. You want to stand up?
La Misha. Generation here today. They are old timers like me. There are people in their 40s that have known when they were in Pampers. And there is the youth. The youth is here too. There's even one of my son's best friends, Mr. Francisco da Costa, in the back. Strength of this movement now is a coalition that has get endorsement of more than 40 organizations, and a very powerful connection with the unions. You know that up to now the unions were very shy about political ability because they didn't want to piss out the POA. That time is over.
Yeah.
We are not going anywhere. Who is here on the plaza today? The real San Francisco. Yeah. Heck with the new San Francisco. We're here to say, Amor for Alex, justice for Mario Wood.
Yeah.
Thank you, La Misha. Thank you. Now we have another powerful rapper.
Let's get justice for Cameron Boyd. Let's get justice for Kenneth Hardy. Let's get justice for Mario Woods. And let's damn sure get justice for Alex Nieto. I want everybody out here to know San Francisco is under attack, like our brother was when he was up on that hill eating his burrito, minding his own business. The exact same way we are under attack in San Francisco. It might not have been by murderous, killer, madmen, psychopathic police, but it's the same way with madmen, psychopathic, corrupt mayors, board of supervisors, police officers association, the OCC, the police officers bill of rights, all that shit is corrupt. And we need to do whatever we can with people power to save our city and to save our lives. Because they want to get away with murder. They want to get away today. We need to make sure all of us get 4 or 5 people the next time that we come. I'm very proud to see the turnout. I want to see the whole fucking city here next time. I want to see everybody that can relate to sitting somewhere, eating a burrito, and thinking about getting killed by the fucking KKK police department that's here in this city. If you feel that way, and you think that that can happen to you, then you galvanize and you bring people to fight for this young man who has no voice anymore except for us. If he could be here, if he survived, best believe he would be telling these motherfuckers how they hurt him and how they killed him and how they made him feel. We need to do that. Every day, every night. Do not let Ed Lee and San Francisco police get away with murder another fucking day. I'm going to do a poem, and I'm going to get out of here. It's called Cops Keep Firing. And it's a very powerful song, because these goddamn cops keep firing, and they're gonna keep firing. And if I gotta die today for a young brother, black, brown, yellow, red, to have a future, I'm a dead motherfucker. So I hope everybody feels that way. What happened to freeze and put your hands up high? A simple traffic stop with these pigs, a brother might die. I ask why we let it slide and never bust back. Was you only comfortable shooting a gun if your target is black? But anyway, this new Jim Crow breeze, he's killer cops. The real terrorists and agitators patrolling our block. Man, my hand's on the steering wheel. Why your hand's on your clock? I was just reaching for my insurance and registration out the glove box. In high school, they used to be punks. They insecure little chumps. So they get a job at the force so they can dump. 50 shots of the brown and the black, a coward only shoot you in the back. Killing unarmed citizens, what's up with that? Oh, Bootsy ass, I thought it was a taser ass pig. Protective custody, the only way to kill a cop's live. 10,000 young people killed by the police. From Kenneth Harding and HP to my brother Alex Nieto in the Mission Street. Thank you very much. My name is Selassie. Power to the people. And do not let these police get away with murder. Because they can kill my black ass neck, and they can kill you too.
A student, I'm here representing the Power Unit Players. I'm here representing myself and the younger generation, of course. I'm 19 years old. I'm Chicana, meaning I'm third generation, born here in this city. My grandmother's from this city. I got mad love for this city. It's going on 2 years that Alex Nieto has been unjustly murdered by SSPD. He was a student. He was a provider, meaning that he was employed. He was young, and he was Latino, meaning that he was marginalized. So many of us are victims of circumstances in which we do not have the opportunity to choose where we come from. Thankfully, I'm from here, right? I also want to point out that this is not the end, nor is it the beginning. This is not the start, but we are in a very heated time. Alex Nieto, we are the embodiment of Alex Nieto. We as students, we as young people, we as people of color who have been marginalized, who have been victims to the system for generations. We are him, and Alex Nieto is presente. Alex Nieto is presente. Thank you. Let us remember that he was also an active member of our community, doing exactly what we are doing at this very moment. Being active for justice, for our family, for our community, for our loved ones. Let us not forget that youth, although they say that we are the future, we are not. We are the present.
Yeah.
We lead movements, but we are not empowered in this institution to learn that. We are not empowered to take action. But through Alex Nieto, we have been able to advocate for ourselves. We have been able to sit here and say, no, no, not. We have played a huge role in keeping our voices alive, in keeping our community's voices alive, in keeping him alive in memory. And that is so important now that it's going on years to reach victory, to reach justice. It is so sad that it takes so many years to do so, and we're still fighting. I also want to add that us as youth, although we are young, there is still a generation that is rising behind us. And we as youth have been educating them in keeping Alex and all the injustices alive, fresh in our hearts as scars in which we bleed. Our mothers have been crying, our communities have been bleeding, and we have all been dying. We can all be next. All depending on what we wear and the color of our skin. Now that is not okay. I'm here for us to show that we each one need to reach one and we need to teach one. Because the minute we stop doing that is the minute that we forget. And it's the minute that we no longer fight for justice. And that I refuse to do as a young person. I'm 19 years old as I read. I also want to recognize that we have not, as young people, done this by ourselves. We have been constantly pushing, yes, but we have stood in solidarity with every every single person here today and people who are not able to make it. We have stood in solidarity with our elders, our mothers, our victims, our memories, with each other. Today, we are standing here for a federal civil trial. Although we are not trying these killer cops for murder, at some point, hopefully, we will. We are here today because we each have to continue to fight so that we can peacefully have achieved justice not only for the Nieto family, but to reassure that this will not be an ongoing issue for my children to have to live through. I, as a child, don't believe that this is something that we are living in, because I am not a child, I'm an adult, and I will be seen as so. I am not the future, I am the present, because I am speaking now, not later. We are here to accomplish something that SFPD has failed to do. We are here to get peace, and we are here to uncover something that they have hidden, which is truth. This is not a criminal trial, like I said before, but it is much larger. It is about our constitutional rights and those being violated. It is about holding our city accountable, something that our system lacks. Let us not be discouraged. Although this is not the beginning, this is the very middle. And we will continue to struggle until we end it, because they started it. And yet they are not, they don't have the balls to tell us what is truth, what is justice, and what is right, and what needs to be done. So we will do it for them. We will keep pushing, we will keep fighting, and we will keep loving each other. Thank you.
Raima is going to come up here and she's going to talk to us about what's happening here in San Francisco. All right.
Good morning. Good morning, family.
Good morning.
My name is Raima Calloway and I am a member of the Last 3%. Last 3% is the population of the black folks here left in San Francisco. I am from a community called Lakeview, also known as Ingleside, that has been completely gentrified. And when we think about Alex Nieto and what, how he was murdered, it was a direct connection with gentrification. Black and brown bodies are under attack every day. He was in his own community eating his food. How, did he deserve to die?
No.
No. Just like Mario Woods, he was walking in his own community. Did he deserve to die?
No.
48 shots, 21 shots, that's ridiculous.
It is ridiculous.
And we see that over 8,000 families in the Mission have been displaced. You go to Mission, you don't even know what it looks like anymore. The same thing is happening in Bayview, it happened to Lakeview, it happened to Fillmore. This is a trend that's been going on. It's a shame that San Francisco only has 3% black people. We have the highest displacement the highest displacement in the country, besides Hurricane Katrina, which was a natural disaster.
Wow.
So I just want to let y'all know that we're going to be here. We're going to be fighting for Alex. We're going to be fighting for Mario. We're going to be fighting for Herbert. We're going to be fighting for Amilcar. Everybody, because we built this city. Black and brown bodies built this city, and we do not deserve to die like animals in the streets that we created. I appreciate the support, the community out here standing and fighting for justice, because we know that without black and brown unity, we're going to lose. It's time for us to come together and fight like hell. Honor the dead and fight like hell for the living, because it could be anybody. It could be me. It could be you. It could be all of us. And until we tell them no more, bodies are going to continue to hit the ground, and we don't want that. How many of y'all are born and raised here from San Francisco? Are you guys proud San Franciscans?
Yeah.
Exactly. We built this city, we run this city, we own this city. This city belongs to black and brown people. Our grandparents laid the foundation for this city to thrive like it is. We should not be at the tail end of on the plate. We should not have representatives in the office that don't fuck with us, that don't agree with us, that don't fight for us. They should be appointed, they're appointed by us, and they should be running by us. They should do what we say. And we say not no more, not one more.
Amen.
I don't want to die. I know you don't want to die either. So if you are quiet, that's violence. You are participating in the demise of black and brown bodies.
Praise the Lord.
And it's going to take all of us together to unite. If you are black and you are from San Francisco, you are part of the last 3%, whether you want to believe it or not. If you are brown and you're from San Francisco, you are getting erased. In a moment, it's
be here with a house living in this city that I was raised in. It makes no sense for us to be sold this American dream about going to college and coming back. I can't afford to sit in San Francisco, and I was raised here 25 years of my life. Forgot how old I was. If we want to stay here, we want our children to live here, we want our children to thrive here, we need this. More black and brown bodies in the street. We can't hold, we gotta hold them accountable. We can't keep going to them. We gotta start our own shit. We gotta start our own schools, our own institutions for our babies to thrive and live here in this city that they created. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, all right? Okay, now I want you to look around. I want you to look around and see, notice love right now for Alex Nieto and his family, but note here, okay, that Alex Nieto, my good friend, all right, my homeboy, but he was also a partner because he would come with me to homie on the street at Carnaval in all of the positive community activities that we did together, all right? I know that there is absolutely no way that that man, who has never been arrested in his entire life, pointed a taser at police, all right, okay? And that's what we're fighting about right now. That's what they're about to start fighting about, okay? Now, I want to go over a few things that have already been in the media. More stuff is about to come out, all right? But I want you all to know that it will be unreasonable for a jury to vote that this was not an unlawful killing. We will prove by a preponderance of the evidence that Alex Nieto was unlawfully killed by the San Francisco Police Department. All right? We have faith in our attorney, Adante Pointer, and in our community for making this such a high-profile case. All right. Now, I want to talk about a little bit of the actual evidence that will be presented, all right? One, okay, Alex Nieto, we have a witness. He is someone who is unknown to us. He's not involved in activism. He's just a good soul who saw what happened. And he saw Alex Nieto with his hands in his pocket, walking down Bernal Heights. The police aggressively rode up to him. Alex Nieto had no idea that anybody had called the police on him. Why? Because he had done nothing wrong to anybody. The police then jumped out of their car, yelled, "Stop!" and immediately began shooting at Alex Nieto. Okay, all right. Now, they're going to say that Alex Nieto pointed a taser. I want you all to really meditate on this. Why would somebody who's never been arrested, who has less than 2 hours before his work shift as a security guard, that's why he had his taser on him, why would he pull out a taser on police when he has done nothing wrong? Okay, all right? So just question that, all right? Something else to question, all right? The police are going to claim, well, Alex Nieto, you had his taser. He discharged his taser, right? I don't want you all to believe that, because the district attorney had the taser company recalculate. That means they changed the taser memory, the time that is recorded on the taser memory, to coincide with the story that the officers gave. Hey, check this out. That is incredible. And they're going to present that as scientific evidence. Don't believe it. Don't believe it. Something else here. They're going to say that Nieto had his taser discharged at them. Note this. The taser, immediately after Alex Nieto is killed, the taser is on the off position. Guys, listen up and feel it in your heart and in your mind. How could it be possible that Alex Nieto would have discharged his taser at the police, been getting shot, and then figured, okay, now I'm going to turn my taser off before I die? Okay? Right? That's incredible to believe. They have pictures. You're going to see pictures of Alex Nieto immediately after he's killed. Now, question this. If Alex Nieto had a taser in his hand and he's pointing it downhill at the police like they claim, why didn't they take pictures of Alex Nieto pointing a taser and with the taser in his hand? No, they took pictures of the taser like supposedly like 10 or 15 feet away from him. And how do they explain that? They explain it in this way. Roger Morse, officer, claims when he walks up to Alex, he could see it's a taser. He sees Alex is already dead. He says he kicks it out of Alex Nieto's hand. All right? And the city attorney is now claiming that's how the taser got to the off position. When the officer kicked it out of his hand. Think about that, all right? One more piece of evidence that I want to share with you, all right? This is physical evidence. Alex Nieto was shot at over 48 times. We believe about 59 times, actually. But he was hit at least 14 times. I have seen the pictures, everybody. They are in the public media as well, okay? All right, the diagrams of them. I want you to think about this. They claim Alex Nieto points a taser at them, continues pointing a taser, then gets down on his knees and continues pointing a taser. Note this. This is the physical evidence. Alex Nieto is shot in his head. Alex Nieto is fatally shot in his chest. Alex Nieto is shot in his hand and in his elbow. How could anyone hold on to a taser when you have been shot?